ఫస్ట్ పార్ట్ బాయిలర్స్ కదమ్మా, వి డిస్కస్డ్ ఆల్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ బాయిలర్స్. ఓకే, హలో, ఆర్ హియరింగ్ మీ
సార్?
రైట్, ఓకే, యు ఆర్ ఆల్ వెల్కమ్ ఫర్ దిస్ టుడేస్ క్లాస్, బాయిలర్ మౌంటింగ్స్. ఆర్ యూ సీయింగ్ ద స్లైడ్స్? హలో, ఎనీవన్?
ఓకే,
స్లైడ్స్ చూస్తున్నారా?
చూస్తున్నాను సార్.
ఓకే, సో స్లైడ్ ఈజ్ విజిబుల్ ఫర్ యూ. రైట్, డిఫరెంట్ ఫిట్టింగ్స్ అండ్ డివైసెస్ ఆర్ నెసెసరీ ఫర్ ద ఆపరేషన్ అండ్ ద సేఫ్టీ ఆఫ్ ఎ బాయిలర్. ఓకే, these are known as boiler mountings, important mountings which are generally fitted on a boiler. Okay, boiler mountings are nothing but the extra fittings which are necessary for the operation and the safety of a boiler is known as boiler mountings. Okay, certain important boiler mountings. What is this? List of boiler mountings. Okay, what are they? Water level indicator, steam stop valve, hello, safety valve, blow off cock, pressure gauge, feed check valve and a visible plug. Okay, these are the extra fittings fitted to the boiler mountings for the safe running. Understand, safety means material safety and as well as human beings, manpower safety. For these two we have to have these fittings, the boiler mountings. One by one let us discuss. First one, water level indicator. Understand, water level indicator, the name itself is giving the function of this device. So this will give the information regarding the quantity of water present inside the boiler. Understand, the mass flow rate of the steam should not be decreased. So if you want to have the proper rate of steam means we have to keep the proper amount of water in the boiler for the steam generation. It is an important fitting which indicates the water level inside the boiler to an observer. Okay, it is a safety device upon which the correct working of the boiler depends. This fitting may be seen in front of the boiler. Okay, it is mostly employed in the steam boiler. It has a strong glass tube fitted to two hollow gun metal castings with the help of a stuffing box. Excuse me. The lower end of this indicator communicates with the water and the upper end of the water level indicator is with the steam in the boiler. Okay, this water level gives the information of quantity of water boiler. Okay, this is a glass fitting fitted in a stuffing box which is communicated or connected with the boiler. Understand, at the location where water is present. Understand, so for this case, by seeing if any lack is taking places, we have to add the same quantity in the feed valve quantity. Understand, so feed water, however we are sending the water from hot well to the boiler with help of a boiler feed pump. Due to any losses, if quantity reduced, we will add the makeup water. to compensate that loss. Okay. See, this is the figure, boiler mounting figure. Okay. Why? See, this is the glass tube. Are you seeing? This is the glass tube. This is the stuffing box. It is connected at the water, and top is connected at the steam. So both spaces are in contact with this. By seeing this water level indicator, we can easily find out so and so amount of water is presented. Okay. So if any substance deficiency takes place, this scale will indicate it. Okay. Based on that, we will protect the water. See, you are seeing water level indicators. Okay. Glass tubes, these are the glass tubes. So extra glass tubes, understand? Tight, very tight one, fitted it. Okay. It indicates the quantity of water inside it. And come for the next slide. Steam stop valve. Okay, by seeing this title, we can see it. Okay, steam stop valve. It regulates the flow of steam from a boiler. Okay, this is generally mounted on the highest part of boiler shell and performs the function of regulating the flow of steam from boiler. Steam stop valve generally has main body of cast steel. Steam stop valve generally has main body of cast steel. Valve seat and nut are of the brass. Okay, remaining parts. It can be easily operated by rotating the hand wheel. Which causes lifting or lowering the spindle. Thus causing an opening or closing of a valve. Okay. Let us see the figure. This is the steam stop valve. So from here, steam will move, and here it will leave the steam valve and enter the turbine. Okay, see this is a wheel. This is the cover, stud rods, yoke, and this is the gland, and this is the spindle, and this is the valve. Okay, and this is the valve seat. If we turn the hand wheel, what will happen? It will move up because it is a square. It has a threads. Understand? It has a threads. If we move the rod, this will move up. Understand? If we rotate the wheel, this vertical spindle will revolves around the threads and moves up. As it moving upside, from here steam enters and flows to the turbine from the boiler. Okay, this is the simple information on the steam stop valve. Commercial figure. This is the commercial figure. Okay, this is the hand wheel. This is the steam outlet, and this is the steam inlet. Okay. If we run it, if we rotate it, spindle move upside and valve opens, and from here steam enters and expands in the turbine. Okay, next. Confirm safety valves. These are the devices attached to the steam's chest for preventing explosions due to excessive internal pressure of the steam. Understand? These are the devices attached to the steam chest for preventing explosions. Okay, due to the severe excessive internal pressure, these explosions will take place. Understand? So to prevent that explosions and to prevent the damages, safety valves will be fitted. Okay, these are the directly placed on the boiler. The function of a safety valve is to blow off the steam when the pressure of the steam inside the boiler exceeds the working pressure. Understand? It will blow off. Understand? Therefore, a big explosion will be prevented. The name itself, it is giving its function, safety. There are certain types in safety valves. What are they? Lever safety valve, dead weight safety valve, spring loaded safety valve, high steam and low water safety valve. Once again, repeat it. Lever safety valve, dead weight safety valve, spring loaded safety valve, high steam and high water, low water safety valve. Let us discuss one by one. This is the lever safety valve. Okay, lever safety valve. There is a weight. Okay, what are the parts in it? Lever, valve seat, body. And this is the steam inlet. Understand? whenever excessive pressure raised inside the boiler, what will happen? This will blows off. This will blows off, and it will move upside. Understand? And steam will escapes from the boiler and spreads in the atmosphere, so that we can protect the boiler and also human beings. Where those people who are working under that premises. Next, come. This is the dead weight. Dead weight, there is a weight. Dead weight safety valve. What are the parts? Weight is there, lever is there, slotted lever guide is there, valve seat is there, valve body is there. Okay, this is a shutter. Understand? Whenever excessive pressure generates inside the boiler, what will happen? This will moves up. Understand? Blows. Okay, it will moves up from the valve seat. Okay, this is the valve. This valve body. This valve will moves up from its valve seat. So what will happen? From this place, it will steam will escapes from the boiler and prevents the safety of the boiler. Okay, and next one, blow off cork. It is used for periodical cleaning by discharging the water sediments and from bottom of the boiler. Blow off cork, it is used to periodical cleaning by discharging the water and other sediments from the bottom of the boiler. Thermal power plants or any other power plants, if there is a boiler which we will have the water treatment plant water treatment plant also. Okay, water will be treated physically and chemically. Understand? What is meant by physical treatment? Cleaning the water from mud, dust, dirt, any other impurities and unwanted foreign matter. All these things will be removed in a physical treatment. And the chemical treatment is also there, reducing the hardness of the water. Understand? Okay, even though we are having that physical treatment, there are certain chances for this mud or other dust particles, understand, to enter the boiler along with the feed water. Understand? So, these will be collected at the bottom of the water. Understand? Because these stones or mud or this matter will have weight. Because of its weight, it will slows down and comes down and stored at the bottom of the boiler. So in this periodical cleaning, we will open the blow-off cock valve and we'll remove the uncleaned water, sediments and this foreign matter. Understand? So for that we will use this blow-off cock. Blow-off cock has a plug of conical type put into the mating casing. Plug position is altered for opening and closing of the flow. It also helps in regulating the salt concentration, as frequent draining helps in throughout the salt deposited over the period of it also used for emptying the boiler whenever boiler is to be cleaned. Understand? This is the purpose of a blow off cock. And see, this is the figure of the or sketch of the blow off cock. Understand? See, the what are the parts in it? Conical plug. Understand? Its face is conical. This is a guard is there, shank is there, asbestos packing. Valve body is there, casing, gland, valve yoke, all these are present here. Understand? So from here we can regulate the guard. Understand? See, set screw is there here. If we once remove the set screw, what will happen? It will come down. Okay, and all the water presented in the boiler can be drained off from this. Understand? By this we can clean and remove the sediments, foreign water, impurities presented inside the boiler. Okay, next. This is the commercial figure of law of cargo. Understand? Next, pressure gauge. A pressure gauge indicates the pressure of a steam in a boiler. It is mounted at the front top. Generally, Bowden type pressure gauge is being used for the pressure measurement. Pressure is continuously monitored so as to avoid the occurrence of overshooting of boiler pressure. This is a very important step. Whenever required pressure is generated inside the boiler, the same will be come to know by seeing the pressure gauge. The people or boiler operators can check the pressure gauge and the whenever required pressure generated, they will open the steam stop valve and the quantity of water steam will be allowed to leave the boiler into the turbine house. Okay, all those safety devices to protect the boiler against pressure rising beyond the limit are provided, but the pressure gauges are also used for monitoring the pressure. Understand? It prevents the explosions. Understand? Everything will be recorded and represented by this pressure gauge. See, we are saying it is a Bowden pressure gauge. Bowden pressure gauge. What are the parts presented in conch? This is a conch. Okay, and this is the block. Block is there. Connecting link is there. Movement is there. End piece is there. Outride is there. This is the pinion. Okay, this is the Bowden tube. Bowden tube. See, whenever steam generates, understand, this is generated steam enter the cock and flows and moves into this Bowden tube. Okay, as the pressure is increasing, if the pressure is increased, so what will happen? This Bowden tube will expand. Because of this expansion or movement, this is the pointer. This pointer will moves. Okay, this pointer will shows the pressure. So it's 0 bar, 5 bar, 10 bar, 5 bar, 10 bar, 20 bar, 30 bar, 50 bar, like that. So this will move. Understand? This is the working principle of the pressure gauge. It will show and represents the pressure generated inside the boiler. This is the commercial one. Commercial one. Okay, practically, if we can see the image of the pressure gauge, understand, 70 bar, 100, 130, 160, 190, 220, 250, like that, okay. Temperature is there and pressure is there. This is the temperature and this is the pressure. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, okay, understand, pressure. So both we can represent by this pressure gauge. Next, feed check valve. What is this? Basically, it is a valve by which we can check the feed, boiler feed. Feed is nothing but the water, understand? This is a non-return valve. It is a non-return valve. At the end of the delivery from feed, water pump and is placed on the boiler shell. Boiler shell slightly below normal water level. It has a check valve whose opening and closing are regulating by the position of a spindle. Feed check valve permits unidirectional flow of water from feed pump to the boiler shell. It is used to feed and control the flow of water. Control the flow of water. Okay. This is the commercial figure. This is the commercial figure of the feed check valve. Okay. Feed check valve. So here, this is a spindle is there, hand wheel is there, spindle is there, cover, check valve is there, valve seat from the feed pump. And this is the water passage to the boiler. Okay, this is the stuffing box. And this is the body of the feed check valve. So whenever you want to allow the water from feed pump to boiler, just rotate this wheel with hand, okay, by rotating it. As it rotates, it will move up and water from the enter this part will move up. So from here, water enter the boiler. From the pump, water will flow and enter the boiler. Okay. Next one, feasible plug. Wait, please. pre-check valve. It is a non-return valve at the end of delivery pipe from feed water pump and is placed on the boiler shell slightly below normal water level. It has a check valve whose opening and closing are regulating by the position of spindle. Feed check valve permits unidirectional flow of water from feed pump to the boiler shell. It is used to feed and control the flow of water from feed pump into the boiler. While during the non-working of feed pump, the pressure in the boiler shell is more and the feed check valve gets closed. Next, a visible plug. Visible plug. It is a safety device used for preventing the level of water from going down below a critical point, and this avoids overheating. It is fitted to the chrome plate of the firebox. It has a gunmetal body and a copper plug put with a visible metal at interface of copper plug and the gunmetal. A visible plug must be kept in a good condition, replaced annually. Okay. When it prevents the level of water from going down below a critical point. The water level should not fall below the critical point. Why means sufficient quantity of water as presented in it. Understand? And this avoids the overheating of the boiler. It has a gunmetal body and a copper plug put with a visible metal. A visible plug must be kept in a good condition and replaced annually. This is the commercial figure. This is the plug. This is the plug S, plug P, okay, and this is the plug SR, chrome plate, understand? And gun, this is the gunmetal body, and this is the flange cup. This is the flange, visible metal. Okay, whenever the levels beyond the safety levels increased, this metal will be melted and it will move up. You will move up. And this will be opened and hard substances will be removed off from this, and prevention of the boiler can be achieved by this feasible plug. See, in our houses also, if voltage beyond the permissible limit comes, what will happen? Fuse will be burned, understand? So that it prevents the supply of electricity, high voltage current into the home, understand? If high voltage current enters the home, means it will damage the all electrical appliances and goods, okay? So fuse will be there. If any time the current excess voltage comes, this fuse will be melted. Understand? In that way, this fusible element will melt and it will move up, and from here this substances will remove off and prevents the explosion or damage of the boiler. Plug P and R are made up of gunmetal. Plug S is made up of copper. Plug R is screwed to the plug P. Plug S is locked into the plug R by metal like tin or lead, which can be easily melted during this high temperature, high pressure generation points, the times. This is the commercial one. Okay, we can see this commercial one, and we can prevent. Understand? Inside the visible element will be there. It will burn, and the safety can be achieved. Okay. Now I am asking certain questions. Anyone? What is meant by boiler mounting? What is meant by boiler mountings? Anyone? What is the purpose of the boiler mountings and what are the boiler mountings? List out the boiler mountings. Anyone? Anyone, reply me. Answer for my question. Ask me.
Different fittings and safety of boilers.
Yes. These are the fittings for the safety of a boiler. Now tell me, what are the boiler mountings? Give certain examples. Anyone?
Fusible plug.
Tell me.
Fusible plug, safety valve. Pressure gauge. Cool check valve.
Yes. Water level indicator, steam stop valve, safety valve, blow off cock, pressure gauge, speed check valve, fusible plug. All these are the boiler mountings, absolutely for the safety operation. Now, what is the purpose of water level indicator? Purpose of water level indicator.
Boiler lobby of water level indicator. Observe.
Anyone? Water level indicator.
Boiler lobby. వాటర్ లెవెల్ అబ్జర్వ్ చేయడానికి ఉపయోగిస్తారు.
అవును, ఎస్, వెరీ గుడ్. అక్కడ ఏం లేదు. అప్పుడు ఇఫ్ యూ సీ ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ మౌంటింగ్, వాటర్ లెవెల్ ఇండికేటర్, ఇట్ ఇండికేట్ ద అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ ప్రజెంటెడ్ ఇన్ ద బాయిలర్, సింప్లీ. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ స్టీమ్ స్టాప్ వాల్వ్. ఎనీ వన్ టెల్ మీ.
Are only two present at today class.
Anyone? Safety valve. Anyone?
బాయిలర్ ఎక్స్ప్లోజన్ ని ఆపడానికి.
Once again, summary. We call the summary of the information. Water level indicator is an important fitting which indicates the water level inside the boiler to an observer. That's enough. Okay, it indicates the water level presented inside the boiler. So one can easily see by his eyes. Understand? So this water level indicator is nothing but a glass tube. If the glass is there, glass tube is there, then only we can see the water content, water level inside. Understand? Next, one more. steep stop valve. Your name itself, we can say steep stop valve. So we can stop the steam flow, and also we can allow the steam to flow into the turbine from a boiler. Understand? So indirectly, what we can say, it is a regulator. Regulator. We can regulate, control, and meter the amount of steam. Understand? It regulates the flow of steam from a boiler. This is generally mounted on the highest part of the boiler shell and performs the function of regulating the flow of steam from the boiler. Steam stop valve generally has main body of cast steel, valve seat and nut, etc. of the brass. It can be easily operated by rotating the hand wheel, which causes lifting and lowering of the spindle, thus causing opening and closing the valve. Okay. Next one. Safety valves. Safety valve. Okay, what is meant by safety valve? See this. These are the devices attached to the steam chest for preventing the explosions. Explosions due to the excessive internal pressure of the steam. A steam boiler is usually provided with two safety valves. Understand? These are the directly placed on the boiler. The function of a safety valve is to blow off the steam when the pressure of the steam inside the boiler exceeds the working pressure. Understand? It will prevent the boiler and people who are working nearby the boiler from the explosions. Understand? And next one. How many types of safety valves are there? There are four types. What are they? Safety valve, deadweight safety valve, spring loaded safety valve, high steam and low water safety valve. Okay, once again. Low water safety valve. Okay. Next one. Blow off cork. What is its use? See the slide. It is used for periodical cleaning by discharging the water and the sediments. Sediments from the bottom of the boiler. It is fitted to the bottom of the boiler shell. Blow off cork has a plug of conical type put into the mating casing. Plug position is altered for opening and closing the flow. It also helps in regulating the salt concentrations, as frequent draining helps in throwing out the salt deposited over the period of time. It is also used for emptying the boiler whenever boiler is to be cleaned. Okay, blow off cork. Understand? If you remove it, the sediment, dirty water with the foreign amount or unwanted matter will be removed off, so that we can have the inside surface of the boiler is cleaned one. And next one. This is the commercial figures. Okay. Next, pressure gauge. Okay. See, what is the purpose of this? Gauge is a device which scales or measures the pressure. Pressure gauge is a device which indicates the pressure of the steam in the boiler. It is mounted at the front. Generally, border type pressure gauge is being used for pressure measurement. Pressure is continuously monitored so as to avoid occurrence of overshooting of the boiler pressure. Understand? It should not be taken places. However, we have the steam stop valve, visible plugs, wherever the conditions are increased beyond the normal working conditions. Okay, all the safety devices to protect the boiler against pressure rising beyond a limit provided, but pressure gauges are also used for monitoring the pressure. We can see this pressure gauge in fluid mechanics also, in measurement of pressure. Okay, measurement of pressure can be done by in the hydraulics point of view, manometers, simple manometers, okay, feet attitude, differential manometer, upright differential manometer, inverted differential manometer, whereas mechanical gauges are also there. Understand, in the differential manometer, the pressure of how can we measure the pressure means that the fluid column will be balanced by area of the fluid column. Okay, by doing so we can find out the pressure. Whereas in mechanical devices, dead weight pressure gauge, spring loaded pressure gauge, okay, and balanced pressure gauge, Gordon pressure gauge, all these are the examples of pressure gauges. Okay. Next, feed check valve. So what is the function of the feed check valve? It checks the feed, whether sufficient quantity of water is being pumped by the feed pump or not. Understand? Because mass flow rate of the water, boiler feed water, is very important. So this quantity should not be reduced beyond the normal water level. Understand? Whenever losses takes places, we will add the makeup water. Understand? To compensate the loss. Okay, the feed check valve is a non-return valve at the end of the delivery pipe from feed water pump. It is placed on the boiler shelf slightly below normal water. It has a check valve whose opening and closing are regulated by the position of spindle. Feed check valve permits unidirectional flow of water from feed pump to the boiler shelf. It is used to feed and control the flow of water from pump to boiler. Visible plug. It is a safety device used for preventing the level of water from going down below a critical point, thus avoids overheating. Understand? So it is fitted to the chrome plate of the firebox. It has a gunmetal body and a carbon plug put with a visible metal at interface of copper plug and gunmetal body. A visible plug must be kept in a good condition and always it has to be replaced every year. Annually we have to replace it. Understand? It is a safety device for you preventing the level of water going below the prescribed or predefined value or required value. Understand? Water level reduces even though we are supplying sufficient quantity of heat, proper amount of steam cannot be generated and also overheating of the boiler takes places. Surface of the boiler vessel Understand? Or the boiler shell will be damaged. Understand? It will even melts the boiler shell also. It continuously heat the boiler without the water. That is the thing. This is the commercial simple figure of the visible plug. And this is the commercial figure. We can see in any shops, we can purchase it also. Visible plug. Okay, boys, thank you very much. By this, I am closing the session. Okay, thank you, and you can leave now, all of you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hello.